For me, everything starts with basic science. I'm interested in how the universe is full of matter. We actually don't understand why that is, and we don't even know what 80% of the matter in the universe is. I'm Brent VanDevender. I'm an experimental nuclear physicist at pnnl. I'm the program manager for nuclear physics research. We believe the problem of matter can be solved by a subatomic particle called the neutrino. Of all the particles in the subatomic zoo, a neutrino might be its own antiparticle. And that allows reactions that would cause the Big Bang to favor reactions that produce matter over antimatter, resulting in the universe we live in now. The way you test that in the modern universe is to look for a process called neutrinoless double beta decay. It's a very rare radioactive decay. Detecting rare radioactive decays or dark matter is extremely challenging. You have to have large detectors with very low backgrounds. As it turns out, 90% of the day-to-day work and 100% of the technology transfers over into our national security missions. Looking for rare radioactive decays or dark matter scatters is not very different than looking for rare radioactive xenon atoms in the atmosphere that would signify a recent illegal nuclear weapons test. Many of the measurements we make, both in fundamental science and in our applied missions, are very sensitive to naturally occurring radiation. The only way to get away from cosmic radiation is to go underground. We have a shallow underground laboratory where we can get to just 1% of the exposure one would have in the surface. We can then have down there very sensitive experiments. We grow our own copper such that it excludes radioactive metals that come with naturally occurring copper. And we can then build very low background detectors out of that. The detectors we develop for those neutrino and dark matter experiments translate directly over into our nuclear non-proliferation mission. Everybody knows that we're watching for nuclear weapons tests and that they won't get away with it. That's a deterrent to the development of new nuclear weapons. And in that way, our work in basic science really does make the world safer.